Right now, an investigation underway in Canton, Ohio, after body cam video of a deadly arrest was released. Video shows officers trying to arrest Frank Tyson in a bar after he allegedly left the scene of a single car accident. Tyson is seen fighting with officers when they try to take him out of the building. During the arrest, an officer's knee can be seen on Tyson's back, and he's heard saying he can't breathe several times, including once after the officer removed his knee. More than 5 minutes later, officers checked for a pulse. Tyson was later pronounced dead at the hospital. People across the country, especially in Minneapolis, can't help but think of George Floyd, who died after former Minneapolis police officer Derek Chauvin held his knee on his neck during an arrest in 2020. While the investigation into exactly what happened in Ohio is still ongoing, the trauma this brings up is real, and it's happening right now.
Ian Russell spoke with community leaders for some perspective. Ian?
Yeah, well, Julie, Randy, those memories are top of mind for many after seeing that video. And one historian we spoke with says even 4 years after the murder of George Floyd, videos like this show there's more that needs to change.
He's in the VFW. He ran in there.
Very, very difficult to watch.
Unfortunately, Dr. Yuru Williams has seen this before.
Most people will look at this, particularly in communities of color, particularly in the Black community, from the lens of, this is the wound again. Here we go again.
A familiar sight in a new location, Canton, Ohio. Hundreds of miles away, but what we see is familiar.
There's been a lot of dialogue about efforts toward reform, but unfortunately, it's something we've seen before. This impetus to try to create meaningful pathways to reform, but then videos like this that prove that these practices continue and continue to cost lives. Then we see this image of the knee yet again. 30 seconds apply to Frank Tyson's body. We hear him say, I can't breathe.
I can't breathe.
We hear him ask the officer to remove his knee. And then we watch him lie there motionless with the officers and other patrons of the bar doing nothing to address this man who clearly is unconscious at this point. It's just very disturbing. Reminded me so much, the echoes of George Floyd are really powerful. And we think about the way that people responded to Floyd and talked about his criminal background, or he was high on drugs or whatever it may have been. None of that justified the contemptuous treatment of his body any more than anything that anyone will say about Frank Tyson justifies what we witnessed on this video.
4 years after George Floyd, Williams says some things haven't changed.
From the patrons who seem to have very little regard for his life, no one's asking, is he okay? Or inquiring about his consciousness or safety at that point. And it's very disturbing for that reason. I think that there are our contrast here that should prick the conscience of all Americans as they're watching this video.
The body cam video shows bar patrons and an officer joking about the situation. Over 5.5 minutes passed from the time the officer removed their knee from Tyson to when they checked him for a pulse. It took another 2.5 minutes for them to start chest compressions. Paramedics arrived at that bar about 10 minutes.